people did. It's going down now. The planet. Thank you.
الأقدام اللي لحظة تاريخية في البلاد. فنية حدث تاريخي تأسيس البلاد في مطار وننقل ذلك ننتقل بكم نحو القصر الرئاسي
Yes, when you come inside, let you come for one line. Yeah. One side. Those coming.
The cows coming.
Thank you.
Go that side.
Yeah, go one side. One side. I'm sure you're there. Show you, get a show. This squad is going to move here. Going to move this side here. Okay, just please. Just go a little bit like that. Leader, show you.
Go this side. Yes. Come this side. Fred, come this side.
You can come like this.
Okay. You can take a photo.
Okay.
His face. Move behind. His face. Move. Convoy.
Convoy.
Behind, please. You can't even take it when you're behind there. Behind.
No movement.
Just stop there. No more. Keep coming.
Yeah, like this. Yeah. Yeah.
Thank you. Yes, thank you.
Don't go away. Don't go away.
Don't move. Huh?
No,
don't,
okay.
Don't move.
Don't stand here.
Those guys at the front.
These guys are blocking. Like this is okay, just here.
Don't go there, guys.
Those two.
Ask him to stop now.
$500,000 to support helis, educational and agricultural projects in the country. So Sudanese civil and East.
Thank you. ghetto.
Live.
الآن نتجه نحو لحظة تاريخية. والآن مشاهدي الكرام، عدد كبير من الجمهور اصطف جنبات الطرقات الرئيسية بمدينة جوبا.
Thank you viewers for following SBC. You can see all the plaque right here. Thank you so much for following SBC. This is the procession of our
Go.
Okay.
They move the car. They move the car because of the security.
You take it, man.
are crazy.
Let them reduce at least here.
Huh? Let them reduce.
ثلاثة أيام من اليوم وغدا وبعد غد سيكون هناك قداس تراح لكور جنجران وبعد غد الأحد كذلك. إذا نحن وأنتم مشاهدين هذه أغلب المشاهد للزيارة التاريخية لباب فرانسيس الذي وصل الآن لضيوف الكرام. لتو الأمانة العام لرئاسة الجمهورية. إذا مشاهدي الكرام وصلنا لتو مكتب رئيس الجمهورية وسنكون معكم على الهواء مباشرة على مدار هذه 3 أيام لتغطية هذه الزيارة التاريخية. أعود إلى زميلي وزميل غوري أنتوني للتعليق مرة أخرى.
Yes, viewers of SSBC, we have just arrived at the State House where we're expecting to see His Holiness Pope Francis and the President of the Republic. They will be having a meeting and from there we'll see. And this is what is happening now. We just arrived from the airport and His Holiness has now just got into the main State House to actually hunting with the President of the Republic.
Here and what are the different characteristics city, that is Juba, the capital city, and the human are being part of this event.
Come on. Thank you. Thank you. report.
Thank you.
local university. It's been a pleasure having you.
Thank you.
That was Dr. Alcino Modu, the Minister of Youth and Sports, and we are still here at this very crucial moment as we are waiting so patiently to His Holiness Pope Francis coming this side where he will be offering prayers to the government official. Let's have also none other than Honorable Nili Albino Akolakol, who happened to be joining us here at the President Salon. Thank you to hear our views towards the visit of His Holiness Pope Francis and the
Thank you.
Yeah. Thank you. Yes. Life.
Okay. جنور لا يد من يتبدأ خلي دينا فو دجا دينا هو يا بدر.
أنا كلام لو ما دير لكن مسوس أصلاً سؤال ما سو.
أبي زيره.
فري لو راكين لو.
أوكي إن شاء الله كم هنا شو بس نازلي هنا. بس أنا ما هو ما سيشالين بدر. تو أجره يا يا با. تو يا جنور لا تبي أعمل كمان في أجر بقوله كمان كنسل.
هلا ما مري. أنا كل زواج
قال لي تقولي مستقبلي شو عمري هنا ليه تكلم بجيب أنا أنا برا أو طول بكارة فاز دي تايب ما عندي مشكلة I don't know how they are there, UK, Tabijano. Obviously, they buy a pura life, a premium.
Ladies and gentlemen, let us welcome right to the stage the Vice President of the Republic of Ghana, Rasisi, Jessica Rose, and Luko Pay, just join us. Look at your faces.
Okay.
The Vice President.
Firstly, you're most welcome to join the
Lord
in our
business.
Firstly, you just join us, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for welcoming us. Allow me also to welcome our bishops who are here and the leadership of the Vatican, who is also here with us. So, with the arrival of those ladies, it's just the first sign that our priests and priestesses will be joining us shortly.
I'm going to go to the next one.
mic, MC. MC Mike. MC Mike. MC Mike.
In our tent, South Sudan is represented by not just the parliament, the executive, and the judiciary, but also the family of the president and the first lady. In addition, our bishops, we also have our kings. We have the king of the Cholo, His Majesty Munga Adak Padet, who is present with us, and the King of the Landes as well, King Atoma Budwe. You're welcome to join us. I believe shortly we shall have a program, as I understand that His Highness is currently meeting the Vice President and should be heading towards the garden shortly. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Welcome
today. As we are the most celebrating of the testimony, God shall celebrate before the great heaven, and he and the angel, the liberator of the city of the Lord. Your Holiness, you're most welcome to the Republic of South Sudan. We humble, we kneel, and to welcome Your Holiness to the Republic of South Sudan.
From the countries with whom we have relations. Those are the three components that are running this country. They are all seated here. We equally here have our diplomats from the countries with whom we have relations. Diplomats accredited to the Republic of South Sudan, some of them resident and some of them non-resident. We have also our church leadership of all the Christian family, they are equally represented. We have also the Islamic Council, because Your Highness, this country, there is Christian majority, also we have Muslim citizens of this country who live together in harmony. No religious antagonism. We are also represented by the chairpersons and deputy chairpersons of the Council of State and the Parliament. We have also civil society represented in all its sectors. We have also simple, committed, genuine citizens who believe this is their country. Despite the challenges, they are determined that this country shall come out of all the challenges. Also, Mr. President, on your behalf, we welcome the cardinals, the bishops, I'm sure, coming all the way from the Vatican City, all who have in their hearts peace for the people of South Sudan. We are educated, Mr. President, that this journey, this pastoral journey, is an ecumenical, very important ecumenical visit, pilgrimage for peace, forgiveness, and reconciliation. That's why they are here tonight, to listen to your words, Your Holiness, together with your friends. So I give you the opportunity, Mr. President, to welcome your guests and to ask them to greet the audience. They have waited for a very long time. I'm sure that is love for the people of South Sudan and for our global, eminent Christian leadership. Welcome, Mr. President. Thank you.
Your Holiness, Pope Francis, the head of the Catholic Church and sovereign of the Vatican City State, the Most Reverend Dr. Justin Welby, the Archbishop of Canterbury, the Right Reverend Dr. Ian Greenshields, the moderator of the General Assembly of the Church of Scotland, Excellencies, representatives of heads of state and government, members of the diplomatic corps, religious leaders, ladies and gentlemen, allow me on behalf of the government and the people of South Sudan to extend my warm welcome to Your Holiness, Pope Francis, and your delegation to the Republic of South Sudan. Your Holiness, it is the first time in our history that the head of the Church, of the Catholic Church, has visited has visited South Sudan. Your presence in our meeting today is a historic milestone for our country. On behalf of the government, the people of South Sudan, and indeed on my own behalf, I wish to express to Your Holiness my deep gratitude for fulfilling your promise of visiting South Sudan. Your visit will leave a positive impact on our national conscience and peace in our country. Your Holiness, I wish also to greet and welcome the representatives of heads of state and government who are here within us today. I also greet and welcome the ambassadors accredited to the Republic of South Sudan, members of international organizations, members of the clergy and civil society organizations who are present here at this important occasion. It is my sincere hope that our push for peace and reconciliation will be helped by the ecumenical pilgrimage to the Republic of South Sudan by the Holy Father, Pope Francis, Archbishop of Canterbury, Dr. Justin Willoughby, and the moderator of the General Assembly of the Church of Scotland, Dr. Ryan Greenfields. This historic visit of these eminent, prominent global Christian leaders must compel us to engage in deep thinking about our recent history, especially on how it relates to the noble task of peace consolidation and the important projects of reconciliation and forgiveness among our people. Your Excellencies, in April 2019, during the spiritual retreat we held at the Vatican, Your Holiness kissed our feet and asked us to remain in peace. You also told us from your heart to move forward. That rare gesture of humility did not go in vain. When you kiss our feet, my brother Dr. Riek Machar was outside the country. Today both Dr. Riek and I are seated here working collectively to implement the revitalized peace agreement we signed in 2018. Your Holiness, I am aware of the huge expectations regarding the implementation of this peace agreement. I know that not everyone is satisfied with the pace phase of the revitalized peace agreement implementation. But what is important is that we, as the parties to the agreement, are working together in the spirit of dialogue to overcome challenges before us. And we will remain committed until it is firmly consolidated in South Sudan. Your Excellencies, guided by our deep desire for inclusive political process and the need to create institutions where citizens' voices could be heard, we developed the roadmap 2022 that extended the transitional period by 24 months in September last year. We did this to give ourselves time to plan and create institutions that will permit for holding credible and transparent elections. Which are the end game of the revitalized peace agreement? The fact that the roadmap was developed exclusively by the parties to the agreement is itself an encouraging sign in our path to political maturity. And I can firmly say we shall use the roadmap to fast track the implementation of outstanding provisions in the revitalized peace agreement and to build on the successes we have already achieved, such as the graduation of unified forces. Your Holiness, Excellencies, in honor of the Holy Father, Pope Francis, that will push us over the line
on our journey for peaceful and prosperous South Sudan. Thank you all, and may the Almighty God bless you all and our country, South Sudan. Thank you very much.
For you, those headphones, if His Holiness the Pope is speaking, he said in Italian, and that's those of you who know Italian, but you can use the headphones, you just switch it on, it is already set, your headphones, later on when His Holiness the Pope is going to speak. And then after that, the President will ask the Archbishop of Canterbury and Moderator General of the Assembly of the Church of England to greet, to pass some greetings to you. Thank you, Mr. President.
Signor Presidente della Repubblica, signori vicepresidenti, Santissimo Signore Arcivescovo di Canterbury, Sua Eccellenza Moderatore della Chiesa di Scozia, illustri membri del Governo del Corpo Diplomatico, distinte autorità religiose, insigni rappresentanti della società civile e del mondo della cultura, signore e signori. Saluto cordialmente ciascuno di voi, e attraverso di voi tutte le donne e gli uomini che popolano questo giovane e caro paese. Vengo come pellegrino della riconciliazione, con il sogno di accompagnarvi nel vostro cammino di pace, un cammino tortuoso, ma non più rimandabile. Non sono giunto qui da solo, perché pace come nella vita si cammina insieme. E come dunque voi, con due fratelli, l'arcivescovo di Canterbury e il moderatore dell'Assemblea Generale della Chiesa di Scozia, di Gesù Cristo, principe della pace. Abbiamo infatti appeso questo pellegrinaggio ecumenico di pace dopo aver ascoltato il grido di un intero popolo che, con grande dignità, piange per la violenza che soffre, per la perenne mancanza di sicurezza, per la povertà che lo colpisce e per i disastri naturali che impediscono. Anni di guerre e di conflitti non sembrano conoscere fine, eppure recentemente persino ieri si sono verificati altri scontri, mentre i processi di riconciliazione sembrano paralizzati e le promesse di pace restano incompiute. Questa estenuante sofferenza non sia vana. La pazienza e i sacrifici del popolo sud-sudanese, di questa gente giovane, questa gente umile e coraggiosa, interpellino tutti. Frutti e vegetazione qui abbondano, grazie al grande fiume che attraversa il paese. Quanto l'antico storico Erodoto diceva dell'Egitto, ossia che è un dono del Nilo, vale anche per il Sud Sudan. Davvero, come qui si dice, questa è una terra della grande abbondanza. Vorrei dunque lasciarmi per portare l'immagine del grande fiume che attraversa questo paese, recente ma dalla storia antica. Nei secoli gli esploratori si sono inoltrati nel territorio in cui ci troviamo per risalire il Nilo bianco alla ricerca delle sorgenti del fiume più lungo del mondo. Proprio dalla ricerca delle sorgenti del vivere comune vorrei incominciare il mio percorso con voi, perché questa terra che abbonda di tanti beni nel sottosuolo, ma soprattutto nei fuori e negli elementi di spiritualità, oggi ha bisogno di essere nuovamente dissetata da sorgenti fresche e vitali. Vi siete autorità, siete voi queste sorgenti, le sorgenti che irrigano la convivenza comune, i padri e le madri di questo paese fanciullo. Voi siete chiamati a rigenerare la vita sociale come fonte limpida di prosperità e di pace, perché di questo hanno bisogno i figli del Sud Sudan. Hanno bisogno di padri, non di padroni, di passi stabili di sviluppo, non di continue cadute. Gli anni successivi alla nascita del paese, segnati da un'infanzia ferita, lasciano posto a una crescita pacifica. E ora, illustre autorità, i vostri figli e la storia stessa vi ricorderanno se avrete fatto del bene a questa popolazione che vi è stata affidata a servirla. Le generazioni future onoreranno o cancelleranno la memoria dei vostri nomi in base a quanto fate ora, perché come il fiume lascia le sorgenti per avviare il suo corso, così il corso della storia lascerà indietro i nemici della pace e darà lustro a chi opera per la pace. Infatti, come insegna la scrittura, l'uomo di pace avrà una descendenza. La violenza invece fa regredire il corso della storia. Lo stesso Erodoto, nel rilevava gli sconvolgimenti generazionali, notando come in guerra non sono più i figli a seppellire i padri, ma i padri a seppellire i figli. Affinché questa terra non si riduca a un cimitero, ma torni ad essere un giardino fiorente, vi prego, con tutto il cuore, vi prego di accogliere una parola semplice, non mia, ma di Cristo. Egli la pronunciò proprio in un giardino nel Getsemani, quando di fronte a un suo discepolo che aveva sfoderato la spalla, disse basta, basta. Signor Presidente, signori Vicepresidenti, in nome di Dio, del Dio che insieme abbiamo pregato a Roma, del Dio mite e umile di cuore, nel quale tanta gente di questo caro paese crede, è l'ora di dire basta. E dire un basta senza se e senza ma. Basta sangue versato, basta conflitti, basta violenze e accuse reciproche su chi ne commette. Basta lasciare il popolo assetato di pace, basta distruzione, è l'ora della costruzione. Si getti alle spalle il tempo della guerra e sorga un tempo di pace. E su questo, signor Presidente, mi viene al cuore quel colloquio notturno che anni fa abbiamo avuto in Uganda. La sua voglia di pace era lì. Andiamo avanti su quella. Torniamo alle sorgenti del fiume, all'acqua che simboleggia la vita. Alle fonti di questo paese c'è un'altra parola che designa il corso intrapreso dal popolo sudanese il 9 luglio 2011. Repubblica. Ma che cosa vuol dire essere una res pubblica? Significa riconoscersi come realtà pubblica, affermare cioè che lo Stato è di tutti e dunque che chi al suo interno riscopre responsabilità maggiori, presidendolo, governandolo, non può che porsi al servizio del bene comune. Ecco lo scopo del potere, servire la comunità. La tentazione
there is no peace without justice. Without freedom, there is no justice. But also that there is no justice. Every citizen, therefore, should be enabled to make the most of the unique and unbreakable gift of his or her life and be provided with suitable means of doing. In the words of Pope John Paul XXIII, every human being rights to life and bodily integrity. The Nile, leaving its sources and passing through some uneven terrain in great waterfalls and rapids, enters the South Sudanese plain and near Juba becomes navigable. Before entering more bogey areas in a similar way, I trust that the Republic's path to peace will not proceed unevenly, but starting from this capital will take a course that can be navigated and not to be pushed down by inertia. Dear friends, it is time to move from words to deeds. It is time to turn to the page. It is time for commitment to an urgent and much needed transformation. The process of peace and reconciliation requires a new start. May an understanding be and progress be made in moving forward with the peace accord and roadmap. In a world scared by divisions and conflict, this country is hosting an ecumenical pilgrimage of peace, which is something rare. It represents a change of direction, an opportunity for South Sudan to resume whaling in calm waters, taking up dialogue without duplicity and opportunism. May an everyone an occasion to revive home. Let its citizens understand that the time has come to stop being carried along by the tainted waters of hatred, tribalism, regionalism, ethnic difference. It is time to sail together towards the future. Together. Let us not forget this word, together. The course of the Great River can also suggest a way to move forward. Along its way, the Nile joins another river at Lake No, forming the so-called White Nile. It is transparently clear waters, then arise from an encounter. This is the path to take, to respect one another, to get to know one another, and to engage in dialogue. Behind every form of violence, there is anger and resentment. And behind every form of anger and resentment, there is an unhealed memory of wounds, humiliation, and wrongs. It follows that the only way to bring free, and this is through encounter, by accepting others as our brothers and sisters and making room for them even. This attitude, which is essential for any peace process, is also indispensable for the coexist development of society. In the passage from the barbarity of confrontation to a culture of vital encounter, young people have a decisive role to play. Consequently, they should be provided with the open space. May they fearlessly take hold of future, which is then too women. May women, mothers who know how life is generated and safeguarded, need to be increasingly involved in political life of decision-making process. Women need to be respected for anyone who commits an act of violence towards a woman commits it towards God, who took flesh from women. Neighbor is a brother, sister, the great tribune. The history of this country, torn by ethnic clashes, needs a discover of mystic of encounter, the grace of whole. There is a need to look beyond grounds and differences in order to journey as one people, which, as in the Nile, is enriched by the contribution of its various tributaries. It was precisely by the river. And a century ago, the first missionaries to the shores of follow over time by many humanitarian workers. I want to thank all of them. Let us not forget. Let us not forget to guarantee them. I want to thank. Let us not forget the security and support they need for their charitable works. A great river, however, can at times overflow and cause disasters. Tragically, this has been the experience of many victims of flood in this country. I express the closeness to them. Natural disasters tell a tale of that is battered and wounded and from being a source of life. We need the foresight to care for creation for the sake of future generations. I think, in particular, of the need to combat the deforestation caused by profiteering. To prevent a river from flooding, its bed has to be kept clean, leaving behind the metaphor. The cleaning needed by the flow of life in society is represented by the battle against corruption. The inequitable distribution of funds, secret schemes to get rich, patronage deals, lack of transparency, all this pollute the riverbed of human, which the pressing need of any civilized country is to care for its citizens, especially the most vulnerable. And this one. The same weapons that, despite bans, continue to arrive in many countries in the area, including South Sudan. Many things. Here we need many things. Many things are needed here, but surely not more. Here I will mention the development of suitable care policies, a need for vital infrastructures, and especially the primary goal of promoting literacy and education, and only the like all the children. Like all the children of this land will be able to take their future, have the right to grow up holding in their hands notebooks and tools, not weapons and tools for labor. Finally, the White Nile leaves South Sudan, passes through other countries, joins the Blue Nile, and then flows into the south. Rivers know no borders. They connect different territories. In a similar way, in order to achieve a suitable development, it is essential now more than ever to foster positive relationship with other countries, start with those in the area. Here I think two of the precious contributions made. by the international community to this country, and I express my gratitude for the efforts made to promote reconciliation and development. I am convinced that for those contributions to be fruitful, genuine understanding of social process and problems is essential. It is not enough to analyze and report on them from afar. This is a need to directly involved with the patience and determinations, and more generally. As St. John Paul II said 30 years ago, in Africa, solution must be found to African problems. Mr. President, distinguished authorities, in tracing the course of the Nile, I wanted to venture along the path of this country as young as it is beloved. I realize that some of what I have had to say may appear bland and direct, but please know that this arises only from the affection I follow. I follow the life of the country. Together with my brothers, with whom I have come here as a pilgrim of peace, we wish to offer you our heartfelt prayers and our support so that South Sudan can experience reconciliation and change of direction. May its vital cause no longer be overwhelmed by the blood of violence merged in the swamps of corruption and blocked by the Indian of poverty. May the Lord of Heaven, who loves this land, grant it a new season of peace and prosperity. God bless the Republic of South Sudan.
Greetings, Your Excellency, President Salva Kiir, Your Excellency, First Vice President, Dr. Riek Machar, all Vice Presidents and the Diplomatic Corps and the Civil Society representatives, especially greetings to Their Eminences, the Cardinals, and I beg you will accept that all other protocols observed. To sit here with you today is a sign of prayer answered. I first came to South Sudan with my wife 9 years ago. It is the prayer of Jesus in John chapter 17, that they may all be one. In 2019, you know that His Holiness Pope Francis, together with a former moderator and myself, had the privilege of a retreat at the Vatican for the leaders of church and politics in South Sudan. We prayed it would be a space for the Holy Spirit to work. And indeed, in that meeting, we saw hope. Pope Francis knelt to kiss the feet of each politician. 5 years later, we come to you in this way again, on our knees to wash feet, to listen, to serve, to pray with you. We come to encourage the church, dear sisters and brothers in Christ. Remember your wonderful work in building peace and bringing people together. Even today, the Bishop of Kajakeji, the acting Bishop of Kajakeji, has gone down after the massacre yesterday to comfort the bereaved. But we come to listen to the young people, 70% of South Sudan, for without listening to their voice, there will be no peace and reconciliation. And we come to honor the women who have known such terrible suffering and yet to this day are the sign of resurrection life. As at the time of the resurrection, yet, forgive me, my dear sisters and brothers and leaders of this country, but I must say that places far and near, and so many of the citizens of this wonderful country, are becoming tired that more has not changed. South Sudan's neighbors are part of South Sudan's future. They will be the ones who say to you, make peace. That tiredness is seen in the faces of the people of South Sudan. It is seen in the words of civil society organizations and churches who try to represent the people with strong position. When I remember the commitments that were made by you in 2019, I am grieved, I am sad that we still hear of such tragedy. We hoped and prayed for more. We expected more. You promised more. We cannot pick and choose parts of a peace agreement. Every part must be done by every person, and that costs much. But the answer to peace and reconciliation is not in visits like this, but it is in your hands. For the heroic and brave and courageous people of South Sudan who fought for so long for their freedom and won it are surely the people who have the courage to struggle for peace and reconciliation. It is within your reach. It is close to you. You can take it with the help of God. The people of South Sudan are loved by God. Your stories, your suffering is known by God. Your prayers are heard by God. Together in this visit, we will pray for peace. We will witness to Christ who died that all might be saved. We will call upon the Holy Spirit to enter our hearts and the hearts of those who carry the weight and the pain of great responsibility, so that Jesus Christ might see his prayer answered, that they may be one. This evening, gathered together in the name of Christ, we know Jesus is with us. I pray that this visit will be one of hope and healing. Spent together as the family of Christ, following God who brings us closer to one another and to him. I pray most that the prayer that was sung to me this afternoon by a group of primary school children may be answered. They sang, "No more corruption. We want peace in South Sudan. Give us peace in South Sudan." May God bless you.
Brothers and sisters, I greet you in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. I come to you at this time of pilgrimage with my brothers in Christ, Pope Francis and Archbishop Justin. We come in humility, unity, and we come from our different traditions as servants of Christ and seek to share his hope that all will be one in him, that churches and people will work together and witness together for a better future for the people of South Sudan and for the whole. Blessed are the peacemakers, said Jesus, who is the Prince of Peace, a peace which brings justice for all, for families, tribes, and nations. Today we need that peace. We need churches and leaders who are generous of heart, liberal in love, and profligate with God's grace. We need leaders who care about the values by which our countries live, who care about the conditions in which people live, and who act out their faith in work amongst the most vulnerable and marginalized. These things make for peace. All people are essentially co-workers in God's desire for a world in which all people can live life in fullness. I firmly believe it is in the reach of the president, vice presidents, leaders, and people of South Sudan to extend the reach of justice and compassion to the whole of this young and optimistic country, full of people ready to work for a vibrant and fulfilling future. Today, we seek the wisdom and power of the Spirit to help us to discern a way forward, to offer hope to everyone in South Sudan in the peace that comes from God through Jesus, a peace that will bring a chance for people to live as the prophet Isaiah promised. They shall build houses and inhabit them. They shall plant fields and eat their fruit. For like the days of a tree shall be the days of my people. May all political, civic, and international leaders join together in seeking God's holistic promise of life in fullness for all of God's people. And may God's blessings and peace be upon the resilient people of South Sudan. And thanks be to God.
We have some gifts from the delegation of His Holiness the Pope and the full delegation accompanied by the Archbishop of Canterbury and Moderator General. These gifts will be given to our Vice President by the protocol. We have also a visit that will also be given. So maybe can you bring the gifts, please, and give them. And as we are going to leave this situation, please, I'm asking all of you, this time there is protocol. We shall first allow His Holiness the Pope to leave the place, followed by the Archbishop of Canterbury and the Moderator General will be next, and then our President, and finally our Vice President, and then our ministers and diplomats after that. So warm our seats, please. There is lighting, there is no curfew, sung by so many people. Let us enjoy that the global leadership is here with us. And by the way, the sitting you see there, this is after 500 or 600 years. They have come to South Sudan as a Christian family. I think this is something we should all be proud of. This historical situation that the unity of the Christian family, they brought it to this young, humble nation trying to build itself. So we have a historical chapter. At least we are sending to the rest of the Christian world, the civilized nation, please let there be unity. I think we better make our unity, as said by Pope Francis and his colleagues, while we tell them. So, Mr. President, the order of His Holiness to leave first. And I think the church in Troyes. First lady.
One of the unique day in the history of the Republic of South Sudan. And we will that the event has been so remarkable. So we're just seeing His Excellency President Salva Kiir Mayardit seeing off the visitors that is starting with
His Holiness Pope Francis